Okay, on to reading two, Saving the Soil. Let's see what we got. Summary, matching sentences, and matching the paragraphs. Seems to be quite a common pattern in Cambridge 13. So, of course, we're going to start with the summary. Let's see what we can find. Why soil degradation could be a disaster for humans. So, what do we want? Bacteria, microorganisms, antibiotics, infrastructure, microorganisms. And then just go and scan. Bacteria is there, microorganisms is there, antibiotics is there. I don't see infrastructure, but I do see buildings, roads, and bridges, which is infrastructure. So that's the first one. Let's take a look again. Microorganisms, main factor, humans. So we were there, there's microorganisms there, there's humans there. Main factor, biggest problem. Okay, so paragraphs B and C. We should be able to see that quite quickly. Let's quickly check the grammar. As well as plant remains and something, countable or plural. Storing something has a significant effect, uncountable or plural. It holds something, uncountable or plural, and it is the something, uncountable or plural. So the grammar doesn't really help us. So we're looking for plant remains and something. If we can find plant remains, we'll find the other one. Bacteria and microorganisms. Bacteria, microorganisms, decomposing plants and various minerals. Very simple. Plant remains means what remains after the plant dies. The remains of an animal, the remains of humans, it's what remains after the thing dies. So plant remains is what remains after they die. Plant remains and what it said, something about minerals, various minerals, decomposing plants and various minerals. We love one or two words, just one word, so that must be minerals. Great, pretty straightforward. It provides us with food and also with antibiotics. And its function in storing something has a significant effect on the climate. Storing something. Antibiotics, food, also an ally against climate change. So we're looking to store something. As the microorganisms digest, they lock in. That means storing their carbon content. Holding means storing three times the amount of carbon, as does the entire atmosphere. So lock in carbon content, holding carbon, both mean storing. Pretty straightforward. In addition, it prevents damage to property and infrastructure because it holds. What does it hold? Because it prevents damage. Soils also store, now they've used store instead of hold. They store water and they prevent the damage to the infrastructure. So they've actually played on this word store a bit. For the previous one, they use store carbon. This one, they use hold water, but it has the same meaning. Store, hold, lock in. What is it holding? It's holding water. If these are lost, soil may lose its special properties. The main factor contributing to the degradation is the something carried out by humans. So, what do humans do? Carried out means done. What do humans do? In this one, I think this was the most important language, the biggest problem, the main factor. What's the main factor? Agriculture. They tried to confuse you a bit because humans is all the way down there, and then we don't see agriculture around there. So I think this was the biggest clue there. The biggest problem, the main factor, agriculture. Is agriculture something that humans can do? Yes, it is. Okay, nothing really new for me to teach you there. Those are all pretty straightforward. Let's move on to the next section. All right, on to the matching sentences. So the first thing to do is let's see if we can find where they come from. The first thing that really jumps out is that and that. So I would immediately just go and find those two things. Haber Bosch and Pius Floris. Haber Bosch is over there. Where to start scanning? I don't know. You could start at the beginning, but maybe because the summary ended here, it would be a good idea to start scanning here. So anyway, we find Haber Bosch over there and keep on scanning a bit, and Pius Floris is over there. So that immediately gives us a very good idea of where these sentences come from. Remember, that was the end of the summary. So the first one of these sentences will probably be here. The second one will be in paragraph D. The third one will be in paragraph E. And we can just try and find the fourth one maybe a bit later. You'd want to scan for zero net soil degradation. Okay, let's scan for it now. So just we know where everything is. Probably going to be in this paragraph or further. And you need to scan a little bit further and then you see that it's over there. So they're pretty spread out, but at least we know where they are. Then really just go and read those sentences. Try and just isolate which sentences you must read and which sentences you must ignore. So let's find these keywords. Nutrients contained in the unused parts of harvested crops. Harbour Bosch was over there, so we're probably somewhere over there. It's possible that IELTS can go back. Remember, they can do that. But I would start over here. And if your scanning is good, you could probably see that pretty quickly. So what do they say about that? Humans tend not to return unused parts of harvested crops directly to the soil to enrich it, meaning that the soil becomes less fertile. So this is really our target sentence over here. And then there's no quick way of doing it. You've got to read the sentence, understand it clearly, and then run through all of these options. May improve the number and quality. A good thing to do here, as we've done many times before, is just ask yourself, is this a positive feeling to the sentence or does it have a negative feeling? And that can help you narrow things down quite quickly. This has got a negative feeling. The humans do not return the unused parts to the soil, meaning the soil becomes less fertile. So it's got a kind of negative feeling to that sentence. This bit over here is positive, may improve the number and quality of plants. So immediately I can discount that. Contain data, 9 countries, no. May not be put back into the soil, maybe. Governments, no. Damage is negative, maybe, and better for use at a global level. Nothing about global level. So we've basically got C or E. So does it damage different aspects of the environment or is it not put back into the soil? And then go back and compare again. And it's just tend not to return directly to the soil. So pretty straightforward. There's nothing about other aspects of the environment. So you should be able to see that that one was C. Right, so what do they say about these synthetic fertilizers that are produced with this process? It's difficult to isolate the sentence because they talk about the synthetic fertilizer there, but they also talk about the chemical fertilizers over there. This wasn't such a great idea. Putting this synthetic fertilizer on the fields wasn't a great idea. The chemical fertilizers released these into the atmosphere and washed away with the rain into the rivers. Hurts the soil, acidic, salty. Anything that you can see. This is positive, so it's not that, because that was a very negative paragraph about how we're damaging the rain, the river, the soil. Data, 9 countries, I didn't see. We've done that one. Governments, I didn't see. And that one I definitely saw. I didn't see anything about global level. Environment, they talked about the rivers and the rain. So the chemical fertilizers, the synthetic fertilizers, also damage other parts of the environment, not just the soil of the fields of the farmers. Right, I think that one you could really get from deleting other ones where you didn't see things like 9 countries. You didn't see that, so you can delete it. Then also remember positive and negative. You'll delete this one because this is positive. Right, now we're looking at Pius Floris. What do they say? Addition of a mixture developed by him to the soil does what? Where's the mixture? Yeah, they use a difficult word here to describe the mixture, and that is a cocktail. It's an interesting word. It means a mixture. So they use this cocktail on soils. When they applied the mix, okay, there's mixture, maybe you could see that one, to the desert-like test plots, a good crop of plants emerged that were healthy but had also strong roots. So this is positive. They added this mixture to the soil and they got a good crop that were healthy and had strong roots. The control means that's where the fields where they didn't add the mixture. So we're actually just looking at the sentence over here. So they applied the mixture and the plants grew well. And that's the positive aspect. It improved the number and quality of plants. I didn't see nine countries. I didn't see government. I didn't see global level. So that one, the positive and negative aspect of it would have helped you. Zero net soil degradation was done down here. So they proposed a goal of zero net land degradation. It's easily understood that can help shape expectations and encourage action. This one was a more difficult paragraph. You needed to read the whole paragraph and look for keywords. Here they are talking about governments. Policymakers is politicians, so it's also governments. And they're saying that the scientists and the governments can't understand each other. So they introduce this idea, which is easy to understand. Easy to understand for who? For the governments. So this idea of net soil degradation helps the governments to be aware. There was nothing there about the nine countries and nothing about a global level. A little bit more difficult, but that keyword was there in the paragraph. So it wasn't, if you had to guess, maybe you could guess. All right, on to the matching paragraphs. So the first thing that you're going to do, well, let's just be aware what we've used and what we haven't used. We've used B, we've used C, we've used D, we used E, we have not used F, and we used G with that. So when you scan, there's probably going to be an F in there somewhere. We will want to try and find that quite early. And then maybe A, but A is very short and just introduction. So maybe A, maybe not. But definitely we will focus a bit on F at first. But before you even start looking for that, let's just find some keywords and see. The other thing I want you to remember is maybe we can get some information from these other questions, because it's information that you've learned now already, so it's more valuable and you know it. Maybe that can help us to get some answers here. Let's see if there's anything that we can see. One person for a soil improvement project, how soil stayed healthy before the development of farming. Now that's immediately quite interesting, because I remember we spoke about agriculture in the summary over here, and that was in paragraph C. Different ways of collecting information. I don't remember anything about that. It's also very interesting in the near future. Be aware when they talk about the future, very, very, very often, I can't say always, but 90% of the time, they talk about the future at the end of these passages. They talk about a problem or whatever, and then they provide some solutions for the future, and that comes at the end. So I would look for that one over here somewhere. The future at the end of the passage. And a reason why it's difficult to provide an overview of soil degradation. So, right, I'm going to go and just confirm this one that we can get from the summary, an explanation of how soil stayed healthy before the development of farming. So here they talk about farming, agriculture, and this is, they don't say the word before, but they say in the wild, when the plants grow, they die and these nutrients are returned to the soil, so the soil stays healthy. But then humans came along and this didn't happen. So I'm quite comfortable. I didn't see farming mentioned anywhere else. Here they mentioned fertilizers, I guess, and farmers. But about keeping the soil healthy before humans, I'm quite comfortable that that one is C. So that one we could have gotten from the summary. And remember, because your time is short, you have to do a little bit of guessing. So I'm happy with C there. Then I think I would go and look at this one. Keeping soil safe in the near future, because I suspect it will be in the last paragraph. Keeping some types of soil safe in the near future. This is nothing about that, but this sentence over here is talking about immediate creation of these protected zones. So, and here they mention unspoiled soils could act as a future benchmark. If we want our soils to survive, we need to take action now. So the near future means we need to do something now for the near future. It wasn't very easy, it's not very close, but I don't see anything else. I didn't see anything else about future. I'll be tempted to skip it and come back later, or you can guess. So let's skip it. Right, now we need to find these others, and I would go to paragraph F and find the paragraph F, because I'm sure one of them is going to be paragraph F. So read paragraph F quite carefully. We need an accurate picture of what types of soil and the problems they face. That's not easy. For one thing, there's no international system. A global soil map project. Researchers from 9 countries create a map linked to a database. Measurements from field surveys, drone surveys, satellite imagery, lab analyses, and so on to provide real-time data. Within the next 4 years, they aim to have mapped soils worldwide to a depth of 100 meters, the results freely accessible. So this is definitely about finding data and creating this map. It's a system to gather information and create a map. Let's read our sentences. One person's motivation, no. Examples of different ways of collecting information. So definitely they mentioned data twice in that paragraph, collecting information, and all the different ways are this list here that they give. Field surveys, drone surveys, satellite imagery, lab analyses. That's the different ways. So there's our F. I also saw something about the future. Within the next 4 years, but that's not really the near future. The near future is like the next year. So I don't think it's really that. You could try a guess there, but I was feeling pretty good about G for that one. Right. So now what have we got? We've got 3 difficult ones. At this point, you've got to check your time and see if you want to guess. A reference to one person's motivation. So this stands out for me. One person, we're going to look for a person. And why did they do something? There's a person there. What did he do? He didn't do anything. He wasn't motivated to do anything. There's a person there. He started out running a tree care business because he came to realize the best way to ensure is trees. So he did. He developed this cocktail of beneficial, and then they put it onto the soil. So he did something. And he was motivated to do something. And this person is just talking about, they did something. They proposed a goal of zero net land degradation. But it's her and her colleague, so we want one person. So I would go straight for that one. He wanted to ensure that his trees flourished, that his trees grew well. So that's why he took care of the soil. So he was motivated for a soil improvement project. Then I think I'm going to go with G over here. I can't see anything else about the future. I could forgive you for doing that maybe, but it's more near future. They want a solution for now, and that's protected zones for endangered soils. That is the suggestion. The near future was your clue there. Then the last one, reason why it is difficult, very difficult to find this. So you just got to start scanning, maybe go up to paragraph A and see if there's anything you can see there, but I don't. So we're looking for difficult and overview. And it turns out it's all the way back in F. Remember they said that's not easy. Of assessing our options on a global scale is the overview. Maybe you saw that one, maybe you didn't. That was quite a difficult one. Anyway, I think it's a reasonable passage 2. They seem to really enjoy this format. Summary, match sentences, match paragraphs. Let's move on to passage 3.